We're gonna go sharking, baby. Huh? Baby Fraser's new outfit.
Shark, baby.
So what's up, guys? Here we are, mid-March, and I think it's time we kind of check the line. I've been using it now for 6 months, the Braid, and I've been using the 30-pound Power Pro, and I've been using this knot, particular knot I've been using is an improved Huffnagle knot, and kind of see it here. It has a variation. I have a how-to video, and I'll put it up in the link over here. And it's just a little variation of the Huffnagle knot, but I found that it's really easy to tie at night instead of the FG knot. This is really easy with muscle memory and so on, your fingers. You don't have to pay real close attention as you do with the FG knot in those real tiny, checking on the focus there, in those real tiny, there it goes, those tiny wraps. I'll let you have a closer look down here. So I think anyway, at this point, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go take this down to LMR down in Fort Lauderdale and test my line to see where we're at with this braid, see how worn it is. We've been around some trolling motors, some pilings, sometimes the edge of the boat. It's been a rough 4 or 5 months here fishing. So we jumped a lot of fish, we caught a lot of fish. Let's see how the braid is holding up, and we'll test those knots as well. We'll test one on mono as well as braid to mono connection or fluorocarbon. And we'll see how it goes. All right, let's go.
I don't have much battery here on this one either.
That's all right.
All right.
Ain't much. Say one.
Yeah, go for it.
That's what you want to see. It's going to break. You want it to break the knot, slipping.
At 40 pounds, so. And that leader was, I think that was like 60 to, like 40 pound mono.
Mm-hmm.
40 to 60 pound mono.
It's probably that guy about that thing.
Guy about that thing. So that one is the.
That one, hold on.
That's the FJ.
Okay.
Yeah, the FJ.
0. As long as you don't slip.
And that was.
20 pounds.
And it broke.
Yeah, the braid broke. So the knot didn't break, the braid broke.
That's
what you want to see. I mean, that's what's naturally going to happen is you're going to break at the knot. 9 times out of 10, it's going to go.
It's actually right above.
Now, a customer of mine was showing me what this knot.
The FG?
Yeah, one of them. I watched like the 15-minute tutorial on how to tie it. Said your hard part here is that you know it's used braid, so
yeah,
you know you fished it, so you know it's
almost makes me want to re-spool.
That one's holding better. 26.
Wow, 26.
No, it's those FJ, FG knots where it's the, yeah.
It unbroke and unraveled at the.
Yeah. So it broke right at the top of the knot and then unraveled.
And then, where's the other piece?
So it looks like it's about that time to re-spool, get ready for the shark migration up in Palm Beach. The takeaway from the line test was that, you know, end of the season here, a lot of fish on that braid. Even though we cut off all the bad sections of braid that we could visually see, there was still some, you know, damaged areas in the line there that just, you know, you couldn't see. Once that braid gets unraveled a little bit or gets damaged to the outside there, that weave breaks down and becomes weak. Still strong, however, not what it's capable of what's on the label at 30 pounds there. It was breaking as low as 20, so good to know. So get ready for the shark migration up in Palm Beach. The shark migration is something that's phenomenal. Thousands of sharks flood into Palm Beach, just hundreds of yards away from the beach, and it makes for an awesome fishery. Surface poppers of these sharks have them breach the water, slamming these lures around, and it's so visually exciting to watch. Especially if you're a lure casting guy, it's just beyond description how exciting this type of fishing is. So stay tuned, look forward for that. So subscribe, like the video, stay tuned. We've got more fishing coming up. The shark migration, sure to be a good one.